Hey everyone, my name is Mohith. I am a developer advocate at Salesforce. Welcome to another edition of Developer Quick Takes. In this video, I'm going to show you how to stream logs to your terminal using Salesforce CLI. Having logs on the terminal can easily help you in identifying any errors that occur during the transaction. Without further ado, let's see that in action. In order to stream logs on your terminal, you will need Salesforce CLI. You can install Salesforce CLI by visiting developer.salesforce.com/tools/sfdx-cli. I'm in my VS Code. I've cloned a sample app, Easy Spaces. This app is part of the Sample Gallery app. You can obtain this app from the GitHub of Trailhead Apps by visiting github.com/trailheadapps and clicking on Easy Spaces LWC. The instructions for setting up a scratch org with all the code and the config are documented in the GitHub README for this project. For tailing logs to the terminal, I recommend you use your operating system terminal. Open your terminal in a separate window. For this demonstration, I have split my screen to have the terminal and the browser side by side. We CD into the project workspace. This makes sure that our terminal is connected to the right org. To start tailing logs on the terminal, type sfdx force apex log tail with a color parameter. The color parameter used above enables some basic color highlighting for method, constructors, variable assignments. As a first example, let's say I want to watch the logs for Apex that's invoked from Lightning components as a part of the Lightning app page load. Now, as soon as I refresh this page, you can see that all the logs have been streamed to my terminal. At this point, I can copy this and paste it into another editor, or you would want to filter them as per your need. Let's take an example of how to filter for specific things from the log. So in this example, let's say I want to watch only for SOQL statement execution. So for that, I type the full command and then I use the Unix grep command to say grep-e, dash e is for expression. And in the expression, I type SOQL execute dash begin append SOQL execute dash end. This time I refresh my Lightning page, you can see that only SOQL statements are logged. So I can look at all of my queries that's been executed as a part of the page load. On similar lines, let's say that I'm interested in only seeing the variable assignments that happened during the page load of the Lightning component. So I just changed my grep expression to use variable assignment. Now, as you can see, next time when I do a page load, the logs only stream the variable assignments. Another example where streaming logs to the terminal can be useful is when you're debugging or running your test class. In this example, when I'm finished executing a test class, you can see that the logs stream to the terminal. You can also customize with your own colors for the logs by setting sfdx apex log color map environment variable. Now this variable has to be pointed to a file path to a JSON file. So as you can see, I have a simple JSON file called setLogColor.json, where I want the constructor and the SOQL statements to be of different colors. Magenta, and for SOQL, I want red color. This time when I tail the logs, you can see that the logs that are streamed to my terminal have the colors as indicated in the JSON file. So I have red for the SOQL statements and magenta for the constructors. This makes it easy to find what you're looking for. You can explore more about the CLI commands for tailing debug logs by using command help. Note that you can also customize the debug log levels by using the debug level parameter. To create a custom debug level, navigate to debug logs, click on new, and say new debug log, and choose the right level for the different categories. Provide a name and save the debug level. Once you have your custom debug level, you can run the apex logtail command with the debug level that you just saved. Finally, I want to leave you with a couple more useful commands related to apex debug logs. First is apex log list command. This lists all the logs along with their IDs and status. You can use the log ID to retrieve the details of log using apex log get command with iParameter. Lastly, if you need to retrieve multiple log files from last few executions, you can execute force apex log get with n flag and by specifying the directory where you want to retrieve using the d parameter. In this case, I want to retrieve last 5 recent logs to my local log folder. So as you can see, all the last 5 logs have been retrieved to my local workspace. I hope this video gave you a good overview of how to tail and retrieve logs to your local computer. I hope this is going to make your debugging and log analysis easier. Thanks for watching. If you learned something new, hit like. And if you want more content like this pushed directly to you, click subscribe to receive notifications.